In the olden days, the only way to treat cancers was by chemotherapy. Chemotherapy works by a strategy where it directly damages the cancer cell and kills the cancer. Sometimes the chemotherapy can also cause reversible harm to the normal cells also, due to which chemotherapy has gained a lot of disrepute for having caused side effects to many cancer patients. But just like every field of medicine, even cancer therapy has evolved. Today, not all cancers are treated with chemotherapy. We have hormonal therapy, we have lock and key therapy, otherwise called as targeted therapy, and then we have immunotherapy. So let me outline each of them. Hormonal therapy evolved because of the discovery that many cancers, such as the cancers of the breast and the cancers of the prostate, are driven by hormones in the body. So certain hormonal treatments were developed so that the cancer can be controlled using these hormones themselves. So many patients are happy to know that they are not treated with chemotherapy for prostate cancer, and they are only treated with hormonal therapy to control the cancer. Next comes lock and key therapy or targeted therapy. So many cancer cells have telltale signs or certain characteristics which are unique and differentiate the cancer cell from the normal cells. These unique characteristics have made it possible for scientists to develop certain treatment which targets only the cancer cell without affecting the normal cell. This is why it has come to be called as lock and key therapy, wherein when the treatment is given, it affects the cancer cell only and not the normal cell. Today, many cancers are treated with targeted therapy. Patients do not have to take chemotherapy for many indications. And targeted therapy ensures that not only the cancer is controlled, but in many instances, the cancer can be cured as well by the use of targeted therapy. And next comes immunotherapy. I told you, chemotherapy involves the direct damage to the cancer cells. Immunotherapy works in a very unique way, wherein it helps in recruiting the body's quiet immune cells, or the WBC in our body, which are responsible for killing bad cells, bacteria, viruses, cancer cells in our body. And these WBCs then kill in a physiological way these cancer cells that are exposed to it. By this way, immunotherapy helps to build immune system or immunity in our body. Very similar to the concept which is derived from ancient medical science, wherein it is believed that certain therapies will build the immunity. Immunotherapy works in a similar way, helps to build immunity, and this immunity kills the cancer.